So you do have evidence, and this is a recent publication of yours, that the fasting-mimicking diet in healthy subjects can, it seems, affect biomarkers that are related to aging in a positive way.
Yes, aging and as well biomarkers for aging, as well as risk factors for diseases, right? So this was a clinical trial, a randomized clinical trial with 3 cycles of the fasting-mimicking diet, once a month for 5 days, for 3 months in a row. And then, of course, we looked at baseline, and there was a randomized crossover. So in each case, you'll have a group of controls, and a group on a control diet, and a group on the fasting-mimicking diet, and then the crossover. The results are remarkable. I mean, first of all, if you are a healthy person with, say, a healthy or a low blood pressure, nothing happens to you. And this is a really nice distinction with calorie restriction, for example, right? Earlier we were talking about, are they all going to the same place? I don't think so. So calorie restriction, chronic, it keeps driving your markers down, right? So even if you started, I mean, if you look at Biosphere 2, and these were then confirmed by Fontana and others, if you look at Biosphere 2, even people that had at the beginning a low blood pressure, they kept dropping. And by the end of it, they had pressure like 85 over 55, right? Mm-hmm. And same thing for cholesterol, same thing for triglycerides, almost everything. It really dropped to very low levels, fasting glucose. The fasting-mimicking diet instead, it seems when, if you have a blood glucose of 75, nothing changes. It doesn't drop it even more. If you had a fasting glucose of 106, almost in every case, it brings you back to normal. Hmm. This is very interesting, right? And also very good for doctors. So now we have close to 3,000 doctors just in the U.S. that are recommending the prolonged fasting-mimicking diet, what was tested in the clinical trial. And this is a very important feature. So the 3 cycles decreased in normal people, did nothing. In people that had, I shouldn't say did nothing that you can see in terms of markers, because they already had good levels of these markers. But in people that had elevated cholesterol, it decreased cholesterol. The people that had elevated triglyceride, it decreased triglyceride. People that had elevated IGF-1, probably people eating on a high protein diet, it dropped IGF-1. And the highest people dropped dramatically, came down about 60 points. And people that had high fasting glucose came down. People that had blood pressure that was elevated, both the systolic and diastolic, had major effects. The people that had CRP, systemic inflammation, in almost every case, they moved back to the normal range. So it's really powerful, I think, in resetting the system somehow, that it's getting out of its functional ideal state. It resets it, and I think it really rejuvenates. Now we're doing, we're trying to calculate based on published profiles and also methylation profiles. Is this rejuvenating you? And also A and B, after 3 cycles, What is your risk of for diseases in the next 10 years at baseline, and what is your risk after 3 cycles? And we suspect there's going to be a drastic change. Just, if you think about it, it's 3 months, right?
Right.
It's just...
Five-day fast, three cycles of a five-day fasting-mimicking diet,
and then we measure it again. And of course, all these things that I just say change, but what if we go to the databases and we plug in the numbers, and we say, tell me, what is the risk now compared to before?
Right? Right.
So we haven't finished that yet, but I think soon enough, I'll just say that the results look very promising.